Everybody, it's Dr. Sam Robbins. So I've got a simple tip for you today, something that can reduce your risk for various cancers by up to 50% or more for only about a dollar or two monthly. That's roughly 3 pennies daily. Now, experiments have shown that taking vitamin D can slow the growth of cancer cells, stimulate cell death, reduce blood vessel growth to tumors, reduce inflammation, and also stimulate the body's immune system. And if you already have cancer, taking vitamin D along with chemotherapy will actually allow you to live 50% longer. Now, vitamin D helps all sorts of cancers and tumor growths. However, more specifically, it seems to work best on colon, prostate, and breast cancer. So well that if you have optimal vitamin D levels, can help reduce your risk for getting these cancers by up to 50% or more. And this is important because these are the three top killing cancers. Now, vitamin D has lots of health benefits in addition to cancer avoidance factor, such as bone and teeth health, reducing hair loss, improving your immune, brain and nervous system, improving your mood, reducing infection and the flu by 40%, actually reducing diabetes, and just so on and so forth. Now, what's important to note is that most people, almost well over 4 or 95%, are actually deficient in vitamin D or just don't have optimal levels. Now, in blood tests, most labs have a range of about 30 to 100 nanograms per milliliter as optimal levels, while being less than 25 is being more called, deficient. The cancer prevention reduction optimal levels are over 50 nanograms per milliliter, and I actually prefer people to have it over 70. Now, the best way to get your vitamin D is through the sun. I don't care what anybody says. The sun is amazingly powerful and has healing qualities that nothing else does. Every organism in a man and animal requires what the sun has to offer. Sadly, even people who are living in sunny climates, let's say, for example, California or Nevada, are still very deficient in vitamin D. Remember, even if the sun is out, most of us are not outside getting enough sun exposure. Plus, most people are deathly afraid of the sun, thinking that they'll get skin cancer, which is a big lie. It's true that the sun will accelerate wrinkles. So what I suggest is to cover your face, your neck, and your upper chest by wearing, preferably a big hat to prevent the sun's rays from hitting those areas where you don't want any wrinkles. And maybe cover up your hands, especially for women, because that can show signs of aging as well. Now, I would rather you do not wear sunblock since they're just filled with bad chemicals. So keep that in mind. Instead, go get some sun on the rest of your body parts, all right? No sunblock or anything like that, such as your arms, shoulders, legs, back, and so forth. Do it for about 15 to 30 minutes daily. Do not burn. So start slow and build up. With all of that said, the next best way, and the one which is probably most convenient for us, is through supplements. Even though the sun will accelerate the absorption of the supplement as well, so try to keep, that in mind and get some sunlight either way. But basically, you want to purchase vitamin D3, not D2 or any other forms. Take about 5,000 units daily. I actually take 10,000 units daily, but I also take 1 or 2 days off every week. Of course, the best way to know how much you need is with a blood test. So try to get your levels over 50 nanograms per milliliter and preferably between 70 to 100 nanograms per milliliter. Take it in the morning with food. Now, one question I get asked is, can I get it from food sources? And yes, you can. But I'll be honest with you, you're just not going to get enough and it's not going to be consistent. It's just easier and better and a better long-term solution to just take it in a pill form and try to get also some natural sunlight in addition. So in summary, increase your vitamin D through the sun and supplements. You'll reduce your risk of cancer, look and feel younger too. Don't wear sunscreen. Instead, wear a big hat to cover your face, your neck, and your upper chest to avoid wrinkles. Get direct sunlight on your other body parts, such as your shoulders, arms, back, and legs, and do so for about 15 to 30 minutes daily, and do not burn. Get your blood levels to over 50 nanograms per milliliter, and preferably over 70. And that's it. Now, if you found this video helpful, please share it with people that you care about, and let me know what you liked and what you learned today, and post it in the comments below. And if you're not subscribed, please do so now and click that bell icon so you'll be notified when future videos are available. I have a special link below in the description area. All you do is fill out 1 or 2 sections in the form. We'll go directly to my private email box. This will help me make videos that you want to watch about that topics that you're most interested in. As always, thanks for listening and have a happy and healthy day.